Hi guys, and welcome to overview of book Think Python, chapter number 2. In this chapter we will see variables, expressions and statements. Here you can see all the subtopics which are reviewed in this book and chapter. So let's start with the first section, which is about values and types. We already saw some values like 1, 2 and hello world, and these values has a type. This type can be checked by a special method which is named type. So here we have these two values, 1 and hello world, and if we want to check their type we can type and put the value inside as a parameter. I will explain this later, and we can execute this program. And as you can see here we have 1 is representing number and it's from type integer, and next one is from type string, which means that this one it's a sequence of letters or characters. And for example, if we have decimal number we will have a different type which is float, representing decimal numbers. And if we have number 1 in quotes, we will see that we have string and not number, because this one is representing a sequence of characters and not numbers. And you have to be really careful with types and values, because for example you can be misled by this example here. This is not representing 1 million, but represents a sequence of 100. So in this case you have to think before to use any type or value. And let's move on another really important part, variables. As you can see here we have some values, and we have something which is referring to this value. So in this case we have integer value and name for this integer value n, and here we have representation of this number in as p. So let's say that we are using this number pi equal to this number, and later in this program I can use it in order to print the value of pi. And as you can see we have references to this value here by its name, and you can change this reference and the value of it. For example, I can put 5 here and we will have different result. So this is a variable named pi, and we are assigning value this one, and later we are changing the value of this variable. So if I put output of this variable here, we will have the both values. This is really important idea in programming, and you have to be really confident in this one. And as you can see here you have representation which is called state diagram, but this is not so important. You need to remember that you have variables. These variables has a certain type. So in this example here we can check type of pi, and we can see that this type is integer, because we already changed the type to 5, and here we will get float. As you can see here we have float. So let's move on the next part. We can have different names for variables. As we can saw already, we have pi. We can have pi 5 or pi 4, but if we change the name here we will have unresolved reference, which means that we are trying to access variable which is not declared or already in this program, so we have to be careful also with this one. And here you have some bad names for variables in Python. This depends on the language that you are using. For example, Java or C or C sharp could have different way of expressing variable names. So let's see the convention of Python names. As you can see here, we have a problem with this variable name because we cannot start variable with letters in Python. And other interesting points are that we cannot use some symbols like this one or some other special ones. And another one is that we cannot use some reserved words or keywords. Here you can see the list of all these words. If you try to use them for your variable names, you have a problem because they're reserved for the language itself. Let's move on operators and operands. So as you can see here, you have list of all operators which can be used in Python. They represent addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and exponential. And here you can see some examples. So we can do some of these examples in Python console. So here we can see the output of this one, it's 52. So this is doing addition. We can do subtraction, and we can see the result here. And you can check out the operators and what they are doing. So for example, this one should produce 25. And as you can see here, we have 25. So one important point is that depending on the version of Python, you can have different results on this example here, because you have something which is named floor division. So let's try this example, which is division of two integers. We need to do this, and as you can see here, you have a float number, but you can get integer as a result of this by putting two slashes. But in Python 2, you get zero if you use only one slash. So this is a small difference between the two languages. And you can see this floor division and what is doing exactly. Next point is about expression and statements. So this one here, it's considered as expression, and statement is something which can be executed by the interpreter itself. So these are statements, and this here inside is expression. So if we put here plus 3, we'll get expression inside. So this is a small point about expression and statements. Interactive mode and script mode we saw in previous chapter, but this is the difference. This one, it's script mode. You have scripted statements here, and they're executed one by one, and you can see the result here. And if we start Python console, here you can put some statements and execute them in interactive mode and get the result. And this is very useful when you have some small sequences of statements and you want to check them. Here you have some exercises, And now we need to move on order of operations. They're similar to mathematics in some cases, and you have this acronym here, Pandas, which is a really useful one, because first you have the brackets, then you have the exponential, then multiplication and division, and finally you have the rest of the operators. Here you have a section about string operations. For example, you can do some operation on strings. Here we can check that doing addition of two strings, it's producing a new string, which is a new string sequence of these two strings, which is maybe the expected behavior. And we can multiplicate strings. For example, we can do this, and as you can see, we have several times this value here of this variable. So let's move on the other part. So next part is commands. As you can see, some programs could be really complicated. For example, this one here, it's going to be longer and longer, and maybe it's a good idea we to put some commands. You can consider commands as special notes. For example, we can say that this represents mat_py. So this is really useful. And here we can say that we are testing something special about Py. You need to be really, how to say, you have to use meaningful commands for your programs, because if you put equal to 5, this is meaningless, because we already know that we have this value here, and this is not saying why we want this value here or what we are doing by this one. This is really important to use good names for your variables like this one, and to have good commands. And as you can see here, we have a notation by pep8, which is saying what we have to do when we have commands and other stuff like this. You have also multi-commands. For example, I can comment all these lines in pycharm by using control and slash. And as you can see, these lines are not going to be executed in our final script, and we will not get result from them. And let's move on next part, which is about debugging, because we can have problems with some programs, and we may want to check why we have these problems, and we will need to put a breakpoint in this program. For example, here let's put breakpoint here and check why this value is changed from 3 to 5. We can start debugging by Shift and F9. And as you can see, right now we have variable named py with this value here. And we can move on the next part of the program. And right now we will see that this value is changed by this statement here. So this is all about debugging. You will see many variables, invocations, and changing of the program flow. And this is really important to be good in debugging and to have a way to debug and analyze your programs. Here at the end you have some terms in this chapter. You can check them. And finally, you have some exercises. You can do them. They are a really simple one and nice. For example, we can do this one here. So we can check the volume of a sphere with radius 5. So we need to represent this one, this expression. I will comment this. Okay, so we need to print this formula. So we have we have 4 divided by 3. We have multiplication by pi. We can take it from previous expression just to find it. We have it where it was here. We have pi. I will put it here, and finally we have multiplication by the radius itself, which is 5 in this case on power 3. And we see that we have error here because I put it wrong expression. Right now we can see that we have the volume of a sphere, which is 523, and you can do the rest of the exercises by yourself. So thank you for watching, and see you next time.